नमस्ते बेटिया, हमेशा खुश रहिए। अ वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू यू ऑल। माय सेल्फ जेवीएम डॉक्टर रवि जैन, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ प्रैक्टिस ऑफ मेडिसिन, फैकल्टी ऑफ इनोवेटिव साइंस, ज्योति विद्यापीठ वुमेन्स यूनिवर्सिटी जयपुर। इन टुडेज क्लिनिकल लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द फिजिकल एग्जामिनेशन ऑफ द यूरिन। सो व्हेनेवर अ पेशेंट ऑफ रीनल सिस्टम डिसऑर्डर इज कमिंग टू यू and you are going to examine the patient's urine for physical examination, so what are the various things that are needed to be observed in case of general physical examination of urine, physical examination of urine? So in renal system, we need to observe the following things in case of urine physical examination. Many times patient comes to us and we suspect that the patient is having any kind of urine disorder. For clearing our suspicion about the presence of any kind of urinary disease, the most simplest method is doing the routine physical examination of the urine. For this procedure, the first sample of the urine of a patient is taken in a sterile container. The urine is collected mid-stream. So the mid-stream of the urine is collected, first sample in a sterile container, and that urine sample is examined for any kind of abnormalities or the physical abnormalities for the suspected case of renal disease. So what are the various things that we are going to observe in the physical examination of the urine? Let's see them one by one. Now there are various physical characteristics that are needed to be observed. First of all, we have to observe the volume of the urine that is passed. So there are two methods of calculating the urine. The one is, especially in case of renal disorders, we are calculating the urine for the whole 24 hours. So 24 hours urine collection is the same, especially in case of renal failures, like acute renal failure, chronic renal failure, the complete 24 hour sample, the urine volume is calculated. Then we check for the color and transparency of the urine. The sample that is collected is allowed to stand for some time, and then we observe what is the color of the urine, whether it's white, whether it's transparent, or it is yellow, dark yellow, or light yellow, or any other, or is it turbid on standing? That has to be noted down. Does the urine contain any frogs, that is especially seen in case of polyuria? And the transparency has to be looked for. So first of all, we are checking for the volume of the urine. Then the next step, we are checking for the color and transparency of the urine that has been checked for. The third is urine concentration and osmolarity. Then we are checking for the concentration of the urine. So what is the concentration of the urine and what is the osmolarity of the urine? So we have to check for the urinary concentration, the different things that are present in the urine. What is the osmolarity of the urine? There are two terms, osmolarity and osmolality. So in osmolarity, we are looking for the particles that are dissolved in the urine. The sample has to be checked for. In the next physical characteristics, we are checking for the specific gravity. The more the osmolarity, the more the heavier the urine is. That is, it contains more and more dissolved particles. That means the urine is not getting filtered properly, and there are certain kind of diseases that are present in case of a patient of renal disease. Then we check for the specific gravity of the urine. The specific gravity is checked for, and it has to be in normal range. And if the specific gravity is more, that also represents some kind of disease condition, and if the specific gravity is low, that also represents some kind of disease condition. Then we check for the dilution of the urine. How much the urine is diluted? It is normal. For checking the dilution, we can check for the pH, the consistency, and the normal urine examination. We can also check for the smell, very much offensive smell. If there is any certain type of smell, like is there any smell like acetone, that has to be checked for. Whether the urine is very much diluted or it is very much concentrated, depending upon the solutes that are present in the urine. So urine dilution has to be checked for. The next is the reaction of urine and acid secretion. So the reaction of urine is usually checked by checking for the pH of the urine. Normally, the urine is slightly acidic, but if the urine becomes too much acidic or too much alkaline, normally pH is 7. And if the urine goes between 7 or towards 0, then it becomes more and more acidic. And if the pH goes from 7 to 14, then it goes towards alkaline. So we have to check for the reaction of the urine, whether the urine is acidic or basic. So I will again repeat the physical characteristics of the urine that I need to be assessed in case of the urine sample. First of all, the volume of the urine, 24-hour sample can be taken. Color and transparency, what are the color of the urine and whether it is transparent, translucent or opaque, that has to be assessed for. The urine concentration and osmolarity has to be checked for. The specific gravity of the urine. Now, what is the specific gravity of the urine that has to be checked? The urine dilution, whether the urine is too much concentrated or dilute, that has to be checked. The reaction of the urine to acidic reaction, whether the urine is acidic or alkaline or neutral. These features have to be checked for while doing the general examination or the routine urine examination for diagnosis of any kind of renal disorder. So this was all about the routine urine examination or the physical examination of the urine. In the next lecture, we are going to discuss about the blood biochemistry that we commonly see in case of patients with urinary urogenital disease or the urinary system disease. So today was the physical examination of the urine. In the next lecture, we are going to discuss about the biochemistry. So this session was powered by digital version 2.0, Jyoti Vidyapeeth Women's University. I hope you are satisfied with my digital session. If you have any query, please mention in the comment box and I'll try to resolve. So this was all for today. Thank you very much. We will be meeting in the next lecture.